Planes are supposed to go on long journeys, but as hard as it is to believe, this Harrier has been on some great ones. In 1969, it was a record breaker when she won the race to be the fastest plane from London to New York.
The Daily Mail decided they wanted to have an air race, either from the GPO Tower to the top of the Empire State Building or from the top of the Empire State Building to the GPO Tower, to commemorate the first ever crossing of the Atlantic by Alcock and Brown in 1919. So the Harrier was going to take part in that because we wanted to show they could traverse huge distances and just be ready to go into combat immediately. I took off just after 7 minutes past 10. I checked in at 6 hours, 11 minutes and 57.15 seconds.
From that famous day to many years later, she remained disused and slightly worse for wear and without a home before jet enthusiast Chris Wilson and his team came to the rescue.
It's been a monumental effort to get to this stage. We're over the moon with the end result. The aircraft has been with us for 7 years, and in that 7 years it's been transformed from being a fairly sorry looking hulk to the magnificent specimen you can see behind us. The aircraft has been fully restored, stripped back to bare metal, fully repainted. The repaint was done at RAF Marham by the guys at Serco. A lot of parts needed sourcing to transform the aircraft back to how it was in 1969.
The next part of the journey was to her final resting place, the Brooklands Museum in Surrey, but getting her there was the next challenge.
We have to move the aircraft in a dismantled state. We have to move it on two lorries, and with this one being so clean and shiny, we didn't want to scratch it or damage it in any way. And that's something that's easier said than done, really, because an aircraft being road transported often sits on trestles and formers, so there's always something touching the paint somewhere, whether it be straps or formers and trestles. So get it here with no scratches, no marks, no dings, and job done, we managed to achieve that.
All stages had their challenges, but once there, she was set down next to the iconic Vickers Vimy, who flew across the Atlantic for the first time in 1919.
The original Vimy is actually in the Science Museum, but this replica was built in the 1990s and flew across the Atlantic, retracing Alcock and Brown's famous flight. So it's a wonderful juxtaposition between old and new, and you really get that sense of rapid development of aviation technology.
Final touches are taking place before she'll be on display from next week for the public to see. Amy Wiltshire, Forces News, Surrey.